I'm Lucy Reimer.
I'm Jermaine Purifoy. I don't know, I was next. Sorry.
You're going next.
I am Jermaine Purifoy, people.
And I'm Kathy Davini.
And we're here with your Bradley B.
We are having a great day today.
We are
looking
forward
to the museum gala.
Yes, I know. I'm looking forward to it. And we're happy to have Jermaine here with us.
The
today.
World back traveler.
Back
the
in
world
town.
Traveler.
The I'll famous spend, Jermaine Purifoy.
Feels, oh, Lord. Now, I feel so out of the loop because I've been out on the road, but, you know, I still get all of our text for like committee, so I've still known what's going on without being present, because Lucy definitely does a great job of keeping everyone informed. So I am excited about the gala. It seems crazy that it's a year already, like from our last one.
You know, it's gone really, really fast.
It's upon us again.
And I know everybody, you know, keeps asking, "Are you and Jermaine doing your thing?" And I'm like,
I know.
Well, just because that, to me, that was so personal and fun full of life and entertainment.
We had a blast. And the cool thing is, I was speaking to Lucy, you know, last night that I was like, you know, I wasn't on Christmas tour, you know, last year. So we had the whole month of December to prepare. And even before that, you and I were rehearsing. And so, you know, I've been living on a tour bus for 4 months. So it's been hard for us to get together. But you just never know.
But you never know. And I will say,
what we're
Wes
cooking
Siepen
up.
Is playing piano during cocktail
is
hour.
Is he really?
Oh, see, that is
so
nice.
You, who knows? You never know what
this
might
all
happen.
Listen, me and Lucy performing together happened all by accident.
It did. Not it
accident,
did
but
happen.
It just kind of happened
by accident.
At History Happy Hour.
It was an Okoye Society.
Oh, Okoye Society, yes.
And we had
a little jam session at the end.
A little, he was there playing.
Robert. I was about to say Robert, yes.
Robert was there playing. And we were like, let's go sing a song.
Let's go sing.
I don't know why we decided to sing.
And we attracted a crowd.
And then we attracted a crowd.
Imagine that.
We should have put out like a jar or something.
Jar,
we'd have had
know.
Some tips. And then that led into, well, you guys can come sing at the gallery for Miss Jamie.
Yeah.
And then, you know, what we thought was very tongue-in-cheek last year, our performance, which it was, but it was also, you know, well-prepared. And it was informative because we put all the things that have been happening with the museum. We put music to you know, the narration of everything.
Yeah.
And so it was quite, it was Lucy's idea. That's what I say. It was really Lucy's idea. And then I came and I just helped.
You had some great musical
you know,
talent to help pull it off.
You know,
together.
And so it was a fun time. And I told Lucy, that's the world of show business. If you're great once, you gotta do it again and again.
So
the pressure.
We will see.
You know?
If it has
so
paid
we'll
off.
See.
You know, I just hired a yacht rock band this time.
Yeah, right.
Well, you know, if you
and
can't have
great.
Me, Jermaine, you can have some
they're
yacht
great.
Rock.
Yeah,
they are going to be great.
Absolutely.
Monsters of Yacht. And, of course, what really matters is we're raising money for a great cause, which
yes.
is you arts
so
and culture
many,
in our community
so
and history. And
programs coming
programs
up.
Programs.
We've got to pay for that.
We do have to pay for that. Because there's a lot coming up at the museum. Of course, we've got Mardi Gras we're calling it Mardi Gras at the museum, which is presented by Music Under the Stars.
Yes.
So Music Under the Stars presents Mardi Gras at the museum. Anyways, we're having a Mardi Gras at the museum on February 21st.
Yes.
With a brass band coming on Fat Tuesday. So that's going to be a lot of fun.
It's going to be so much fun. I'm really looking forward to that. I'm looking for my purple and green attire.
Yep. The Storytellers Guild is
I'm just getting
you know,
a visual of it right now, what Kathy is going to wear. And I cannot wait.
It's going to be so much fun.
We're going to have a great time, so don't miss that.
Yes. Of course, I'm really planning for summer camps right now. And one thing that I'm really trying to do this year is to make summer camps free for all of the children that participate. Last year, we were able to do that for Missoula Children's Theater. There were 45 kids, I think, that ended up participating in that camp, and none of them had to pay to be there. Week-long camp, full-day program. So,
and that was a life-changing opportunity, I think, for those kids.
Oh, they loved
really
it.
Do.
They loved
I
it. I mean, it was a great program. And Missoula will be back. Again, this year the play is going to be Cinderella. So we will do that again. And then I'm hoping to either do a STEAM camp. Or there's
well, that
another
was successful last
that was
year.
With Creative Discovery Museum, and if I get enough sponsorships and we raise enough money, then I can provide that for free. And you know, we aim to do the same thing with field trips in our education program, but again, it costs money to provide those services. So
well, it costs money to get those trunks to the schools and then pay somebody to talk about the trunks and be in the classrooms.
Right.
But so many children benefit from that one person that goes into that classroom.
Right.
It's very important.
And it's so much fun. to be hands-on in this process. I've gotten to go and do several of our trunk presentations, and the kids really do love it because, you know, it's a hands-on history experience. So mm-hmm. a lot of times, you know, when kids are learning about history, it's not their favorite subject because it's out of reach and it's distance and it's already happened. And so our educational trunks really do kind of bring history to life because the kids can pass around different artifacts and they can put on, you know, a Revolutionary War, like a soldier's uniform, or they can practice writing with a quill pen, or early farm and home trunk. All the kids love that because it's full of toys. So they get to pass around corn husk dolls and the Jacob's ladder, like it's just a little wooden thing and you flip it one way and then, you know, it kind of falls down, and the kids love that. And you know, it's just a lot of fun.
Well, you said the key thing is hands-on, and that's what's special, because when you think history, you, especially for kids, it's like, oh, like, oh my God, are we gonna get read to, like, we, you know, history like
and
that.
But
like you said, it's hands-on. You get to be creative and wear costumes and stuff. Like that keeps kids' attention. So that's a special thing. That's a really special thing.
It is. So when we raise money at the gala, and that's one of the things that we're raising money for. The other thing, of course, is the concerts and the musical performances and the cultural activities that we have going
on.
And then there's things like, you know, to have a museum, you kind of have to have a building.
And air conditioning.
And air conditioning.
We're always raising money for something, basically, is what's happening.
You have to, you know, there's, it costs a lot of money to maintain a 19,000 square foot building. And to create this place that our community can come for any type of event, whether it's a concert or a play or a summer camp or to tour our exhibit, which we've got some really exciting exhibits coming up. One that I'm really looking forward to is the Forest Service is coming in, and they're going to be, they're creating their own exhibit in our rotating area that's going to be all about what you can experience in the Cherokee National Forest.
Oh, cool.
Here. So I'm excited about that one. We've got some fun program coming up at Smokey the Bear's 75th. Anniversary year or birthday.
Oh, really?
Year. Yeah. So I hope to have a little Smokey the Bear going on this year. We have another fun thing coming up. It's not until April, but it's Tartan Day. And we have had a tartan created and registered with the Scottish Register of Tartans for the city of Cleveland.
Now, tell everyone what a tartan is.
It's a plaid.
Yeah.
It's a plaid that's woven together. So we've got our very own Spirit of Cleveland, Tennessee plaid. Or tartan, as it's called, and we will be celebrating Scottish heritage in, you know, the region, the Appalachian region. On April 6th, the Chattanooga Pipe Band is going to come up and play bagpipes that night, and we're going to hopefully, you know, show the town our tartan.
And maybe people should bring their own if they have one.
Yeah, maybe they should if they have their own tartan. So, I mean, that's just a few of the things coming up, and then, of course, we've got conservation camp is already planned.
Bring your tartan, Jermaine.
I will bring my tartan.
Are you going to be wearing it like a kilt?
I've never done it, but I'd be willing to. I know people who do that, and so I'd wear it. I'm a lover of Irish things, bagpipes, of course. You know, I sing with Keith and Kristen Getty, and they're Irish, so I'm just a lover of Irish music, and so that's going to be fun. Yeah. But I had never heard the term tartan before.
Yeah.
So
it's Scottish. It's specifically the Scottish part.
Specifically, right. Okay. Mm-hmm. Well, cool. Well, if you guys know what that is and you do have a tartan, please bring,
bring it. We want to see
tartan. And then, of course, just the very next week is Keg, Cork, and Barrel.
Oh, my gosh. One of my most favorite events.
Literally, Keg, Cork, and Barrel is your favorite event.
It is so much fun. I mean, we have all of our local restaurants that are there providing food. And then we've got our local, like, we try to stick with, like, local and regional, like craft beers.
But it's outside,
and
most
it's outside,
of them.
Which
I love being outside.
You've got the VIP indoors. Mm-hmm. And so anyways, it's a fun event to have. It's
so
a great way
fun.
For the community to come
Never
together.
Never miss any of these events.
No,
absolutely
not. We've got some super fun history happy hours coming up. But I'm going
to
talk about something else that's fun.
We
is eating thumbprint cookies is fun.
Well, let's have one, Jermaine. Lucy can't have one.
I'm not going
to eat one for her.
Oh,
yeah,
okay.
I'm not
going to
eat one, but
so
I do love
they're
them.
They're butter.
Mm-hmm. I'm not going to eat one.
No? Nope.
I'm
going to
do yellow.
I'm eating your do it.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. I'll do this one. All right.
And who brought us these is Bailey Jones.
Oh, yeah.
From the Village Bakeshop.
Bailey
and
is such
the
a
Diving
great guy.
Mouse.
Mm-hmm.
And
oh,
so
really
he's going to be here with us today, telling us all that's going on down there at the Diving Mouse and making me hungry. So
Oh,
we'll
so
be
good.
Right back with Bailey Jones. And we're back with Bailey Jones from the Diving Mouse.
Yeah, and the Village Bakeshop. So.
Oh, okay.
So, yeah, so this weekend, it's we just last night, happy Friday the 13th. It's very spooky. And last night, we just had our open mic night, which we have every Thursday night at the Diving Mouse. It's musicians from all over come. It's the largest open mic in the Chattanooga area.
Oh, wow.
So, I mean, there's music cases everywhere, and, you know, Thursday night's one of our biggest music nights, and it's up to 20 to 30 musicians will be there.
Wow. And they're good.
And they're really good. And I know
I
y'all too.
I haven't made it out there.
I haven't made it out there.
I've seen these two sing at the gala last year.
Oh,
Lord. Happen?
I'm telling you, everybody's like, are you going to do it again? And I keep saying no.
I told Lucy, welcome to the world of show business. You have one great performance and you have to repeat it over and over again.
Maybe we should show up at open mic night.
Maybe we should.
I think you should.
I absolutely.
It'll be like a bunch of rock and roll and then we'll come and sing some jazz standards.
We'll do some. Yeah. We'll fit in somehow.
We'll slow it down.
Yeah, I like going because it's a big variety of music. Mm-hmm. The talent is very, very good. Like mm-hmm. you'd be surprised. Yep. How great it is, because I think of sometimes open mic night as people that just want to.
It turns into karaoke kind of
karaoke.
Thing.
Yeah,
it's not like that. It's more of like an open stage, like bring your whole band.
Right.
You know, we have full bands that come. We have bands that come that pick up new band members. You know, bands form there. I mean, it's been a really great thing that's kind of Jeff Renfro's helped us put on. And every Thursday night, and it's just it's really become a really good music area for Cleveland.
Yeah.
And a lot of people appreciate that.
So I never thought it'd be that. So, qualifications? Like, you have to have played an instrument before?
It's kind of, we have comedians. So, lately, the last couple weeks, we have a comedian tour from Chattanooga come through. They bring their own MC. There's about four or five comedians that come up, so it's about a 45-minute show. Normally that starts right at 8 and it goes to 8:45, and they're, you know, it's pretty funny. You know, they're working on their jokes and they're working on how it is to mm-hmm. perform on a stage in front of people. So it's a
great opportunity for them.
So
and that's the same time as open mic night. That's what
That's what's kicked it off the last couple weeks. You know, it's hopefully they weren't here last week, but they'll probably be here this week every about twice a week a month. They're here, so it's. You know, we start off with that, and then we start off with some big bands, little bands, singles, you know, husband and wife.
I think Kathy should go do stand-up comedy.
Hey.
You should go do stand-up. You know what? If no one laughs, you got me and Lucy. But Kathy's very funny, as we all know. Kathy would be great doing stand-up. That's awesome. You know, it's very reminiscent because years and years ago is making me kind of have a deja vu moment. I remember down in Chattanooga on Brainerd Road when Mocha mm-hmm. was open, and I was the lead singer for the house band for years there, and we did open mic on Thursday nights, and it turned out that was like our money making night, even
more so
than like the regular Friday mm-hmm. and Saturday night crowd. Mm-hmm. The Thursday night crowd was just booming, and so I miss hosting. I used to host, and of course I'm the singing host, so like mm-hmm. if it wasn't a lot of people, then I could fill up time, but it was not karaoke. It was like really talented people, like you were saying, coming through.
I was really
so
surprised.
Hearing you talk about it as being, it's very reminiscent. I definitely, mm-hmm. I've been meaning to come by there and check it out.
Well, you haven't been in town, but when you're in town, let's all go.
Yeah.
Let's all go.
I need to go to the Diving Mouse, not on a Saturday night, after an event.
Right. On a Thursday. Let's go on a Thursday.
But let's talk about what else is happening down there, other than.
So, Friday the 13th, it's the, who do we have? Oh, gosh. We have Patrick Skeleton. He's from Benton area. He's part of the Skeleton Keys. They play at the Bus Barn all the time. Mm-hmm. It's just Patrick going to be there, but a lot of times his entire band comes because mm-hmm. they say that they don't let him play by himself anywhere. So it's about a six-piece band. They all get up there and... you know, it's kind of a smaller setting, so it sounds good, and they just all have a really good time. And then this Saturday, we have a husband and wife duo, Fresh Minds. Mm-hmm. So I believe they went to Lee University. They play, they've done graduated. They play reggae music. They have the steel drums.
Oh, cool.
And it's really cool. If y'all have been to the Chattanooga Market, they play there a lot.
Oh, okay.
You can see them at Clyde's on Main. So those are the what's happening this weekend. So after the gala,
yeah,
if y'all want to hear some fresh minds, some reggae music from local artists, husband and wife, it's just a lot of fun.
Well, I know, like, the gala will be over by 11. Mm-hmm. That's officially when our Yacht Rock band has to leave. That's as long as I pay up for. So people will want a place to go. So yeah. I hope, you know, we are always looking to, generally anytime there's anything going on at the museum, I try to bring the party down to the bistro. It's like, your party's over. Yeah. Now let's go down to either, not the bistro, or the Diving Mouse, because of course the Diving Mouse is the only place you can go around here, really.
Yeah, there's no smoking inside. There's a full outside covered patio with games and fire pits. And
I love the fire pits. So people fight to sit around the little table fire pits. Yeah. You have the cornhole games, and those are fun. I've experienced all the parts, even the scary upstairs with the...
That's not too scary now. The video games.
I've never been upstairs. That's what I haven't done yet.
Yeah, we've got another big screen up there and a couple couches. And
it's kind of a fraternity party up there.
I love it.
I hope so. I won't say who, but I mean, I hope they come.
No, it's fun.
So we've got games and stuff up there. And
a king chair.
Oh, yeah, we've got the king chairs. And we've got the old... hair dryers and stuff you can take pictures with. So
it's a lot of fun. We always enjoy going there. And you've got food.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. So we have it's a full bar, and we have late night snacks, paninis by the menu was done by Wesley True at True. Mm-hmm. So they're the food's pretty good.
It's good.
It's good snacking.
And there's what I like is you can order even they have different nachos. So if you're sitting around, everybody's sitting around having a beer, having whatever, you can just kind of pick and snack and just keep things rolling out there. It's a lot of fun. We go and hang out with our friends there a lot.
I've hung out there with you.
I know you have.
It's a lot of fun. Well, if you don't mind, if I could just be a music nerd for just a second, for any musicians that are like watching and they want to get involved in open mic, like who do they need to contact?
So they can find Jeff Renfro on Facebook. Mm-hmm. He does... he's an old musical from Convertible Band around Cleveland. I mean, he's had Harleys on his stage, revving them up. Yeah. So everyone knows Jeff Renfro. So reach out to him on Facebook or just show up.
You know, I think you can just sign up when you get there.
Cool. Yeah.
I think you can just go, and I want to say there's a list. Is that wrong?
No, it's just find Fro. He'll be in the mouse hat, and... it's just, he does not have an afro.
He won't be hard to find.
But it's, you'll see, he'll ask you what you're doing, what you play, and he might stick you with, you know, the whole house band, or put you with the new band, or maybe you play by yourself, or you could play the stand-up bass with your own karaoke.
It's fun because you never know what's coming.
So it's just a big old jam session, which I love. It's just a big old jam session.
Yeah, it gets, yeah, they get to jamming sometimes, and sometimes it's like, all right, hey, we got some more people.
Yeah.
That sounds great. Yeah. You know, I listen to this all night, but, you know, there's some people that travel from Chattanooga.
Right.
Let's give them a turn. So we try to give everybody a turn, and sometimes not everyone gets a turn, but there's a stage is so small, and we only have so much time. So. Mm-hmm.
But another nice thing is you can be outside and still participate
and still
with the band inside. Mm-hmm. So I like to sit by the fire pit. I mean, we say a fire pit. It's a table with a nice flame.
Right.
For atmosphere, and you can be outside at the picnic table but still hear everything because the doors are open. And so what looks like a small space is actually a large space because it includes all of the
outdoor it's all glass area. I mean, it's floor to ceilings glass, and it's just it makes it feel a lot bigger than it is. It's not that big, so it makes it feel a lot bigger than it actually is.
And you all have been down there how long? Is
about 3 years now.
Okay.
So we opened up in July of 2019. You know, we're going and rocking, and COVID hit, and we did online Facebook events for some bands and raised money for artists that were unable to play. So we did several of those, and those were a big hit, and it was a lot of fun just sitting there by myself. This band's over there just rocking out. We did that a few times.
And, that's great.
So then we reopened up, and so it's been about 3 years, and it's been a whole lot of fun.
Well, tell us what's going on with the Village Bake Shop.
So Village Bake Shop, you know, we sell the best and the greatest thumbprint cookies around
the whole wide world.
So we have that. We started our online business there, and we sell a lot of thumbprint cookies online. So if you don't live around, don't worry, You can order them online, and they'll get to you in a couple days.
So how far away have you been shipping Thumbprint cookies?
California, New York, Miami. We keep it all in the U.S. And, you know, this Christmas, it was, I mean, there was, we just started doing our online orders. And it was, you know, when you got to ship out about 60 packages a day, it kind of
good gracious, involves, that's a lot. Yeah,
your day job kind of gets in the way a little bit.
Well, what's really fun about those is they can make the little dots different colors.
Yeah.
So you can do themes or wedding themes or Mardi Gras themes.
Hint, hint. And so we've got our Mardi Gras party coming up at the museum.
Another segue into Mardi Gras.
It's actually Mardi Gras. on a Tuesday. So.
Oh, fun.
It's going to be fun.
Yeah.
What day is Fat Tuesday?
It's February 21st.
Okay.
Yep. So that's another one. You know, I'm going to warm up a crowd for you. And then I'm going to send them down to the diving mouth.
Well, that's going to be great.
Raring to go.
We've always got great bartenders there.
Right, right.
I mean, Jody and Laura are amazing.
Yeah.
Of course, we know them from True. And so it's great to walk in there, and they immediately know what you want.
Yeah.
Don't even have to say anything. Before you actually get to the bar, it's on the bar waiting for you. Oh, yeah. I love that.
That's the best service we can
offer.
It
is the best service. Yeah.
It is wonderful.
And it's a good distance from a museum because it's not far. So, you know, sending everyone from a museum event to the diving mouse is always easy because it's literally down the street.
And there's plenty of parking.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
It's easy to park and easy to walk whatever side you park from to go to and enjoy.
So, yeah, if y'all are coming from a museum, please drive responsibly. If y'all need a ride, get a ride. And please be responsible.
Or you can walk.
It's a nice walk, especially in the middle of December, how nice it is outside.
So nice.
Yeah, look, I'm in tank top.
You know?
In January.
I know.
It feels like spring today. It really does feel like spring today.
How nice.
Do you, a question for you, like, would you ever feel like, as the Diving Mouse expands, like, would you feel like at some point in time there would be the need to be in a bigger, you know, space? Because I love the intimate space. I love it. But with so many amazing things happening, you know, would you feel like at some point in time, okay, you know, just hypothetically speaking, that we need to, like, we've outgrown this space?
Yeah, I mean, it's kind of, you know, it's kind of its own product. You know, it's got a nice little area. It's in the covered patio, and it's not, you know, it's more so just a kind of a hobby. And it's, you know, just focus on music and the musicians around, and just kind of, you know, leave it as that, not try to.
It's a great service for our city. I mean, it's a great place to go, like Lucy said, after events, even if there's nothing else going on. It's a great place to go hang out. I mean, we're so excited to have that in Cleveland.
Yeah, it's that's what I hear, and it's, you know, real fortunate to own it and create that, and never thought anything like that would happen. And it's a lot of people tell me how much they love the music and what we're doing for the music scene. So.
And another thing is you attract all ages.
Yeah, it's not.
There are students, there are old people, there are, you know, all kinds of people.
Yeah, there's Silver's there. You know, my grandma's been there, and her painting's right above the fireplace.
Nice.
And there, if y'all look on the stage, it's got a fireplace. And my grandma, we got a Doc Hollywood from the Whoop FM got that painting done of my grandma. And I said, this belongs above a fireplace. I need to build a fireplace. So built a fireplace. And the story how the Diving Mouse started is when Wesley True came here, I told him that I'd like to open a bar here. It'd be a cool little place. And Wesley goes, all right, let's do it. So in 6 days, that Monday, or 5 days, in 5 days, working nights, built the bar, opened the bar, had live music, and we might have been bootlegging liquor and beer.
What kind of place?
Sounds like a good time.
It took $600. So we got some old refrigerators that the bistro threw out, and, you know, just tinkered on them a little bit, cleaned them up, and they start working again somehow, and they're still working. I'm praying, I clean them, and they're still working great. Actually, one's broken, but yeah, just it literally started in 1 week.
That's amazing.
That is.
And we had the big mouse head that has the, he's got a full Santa outfit with him. I saw that in our storage room for Jones Properties. And it was actually from the Nutcracker from the dance studio that was there.
Yeah.
So it had to be Mouse something, and you know, name a restaurant or anything after a rodent's not a good idea, they told me. It was a dive bar, we called it the Diving Mouse. And, it's got its little thing going on, so.
Yeah.
And it's fun to dance there.
Oh, yeah.
We all dance there.
You can dance.
And Kathy makes you dance if you don't dance. You're going to come out and dance on the dance floor.
It's fun. I mean, I love
that. That's what I also love is, like, that out there, like, everyone can hang out, you know. Yeah. You don't have to, like, be inside. Mm-hmm. And so, and when the weather's nice, you know, it's just beautiful at nighttime, you know. And so, yeah, we've definitely had packed out a whole table there.
Oh, it's
so where
been
we had
fun
to expand and put different tables together. So I think that it's one of those hidden gems in Cleveland. And I'm from here, so I'm a little bit biased. But there are some really cool little spots here in Cleveland that people a lot of times don't know about. Like, it's funny you say it's only been around for 3 years, because you saying summer of 2019, it rings a bell. But for me, I feel like it's been around for a while, because my first time going was in September of 2019. Okay. And I was just like, this place has been here, like, in the Bistro or True is right up in walking distance. I didn't even know. They're like, oh, they just opened. So it's interesting to hear the backing story behind that and how quickly it all came together.
Yeah. Well, and it's fun to go to dinner and then walk down.
Yeah. Late night's great. It's just, you know, I know it can be kind of late. Music kind of gets started late for older people, and that's what I hear. But, you know, it's, you have a dinner and you can go have two or three drinks down there and
dancing.
Your evening eyes to dance and
have,
you know,
a good time. Yeah.
And be back by 10. And bands normally start about 9:30 and they get a rocking, and we go all the way till 1 o'clock. So
that's not too terrible or too late.
It's a great place to go hang out. Mm-hmm. Well, we are just about out of time today. I hate to cut us off, but I got drapes to hang. It's gala weekend, so I've got places to go, people to see, things to do.
I'm so excited you came on. Yep.
Oh, thank y'all for having me, and I hate that I got to leave today, go to on a trip where I'll be there at the gala. But I hope y'all have a great
yacht rock.
And your captain's hat. I got a whole captain outfit, so
we'll do it again.
We'll do it again sometime.
Yeah,
and
absolutely.
Maybe these two right here will break out and sing.
Who knows? I mean, you never know. You put Jermaine and I in a room together, and you never know.
We'll cook up something. You know, like I said, I ended up doing an auction last year, which was a bad idea, but you know.
You did a great job with the auction.
Well, thank you.
I've been to a lot of galas, and the one last year when y'all both broke out in song was, you know, it was really exciting.
Thank you,
really brought it up, and it was a lot of fun. I had a lot of fun there, and I hate that we're going to
It was my favorite one.
It was my favorite one.
Not just because we were performing, just overall the theme. Everything. It was so much fun.
We had a really good time.
Yeah, so make sure y'all get, how do the tables sold out?
It's sold out, so next year,
around this time, don't miss the museum gala.
But we really should.
Let's do a history happy hour where people can wear their hats, because, like, Bailey needs to be able to wear his Yacht Rock hat, like a follow-up.
A follow-up.
He's got a whole captain suit.
I got a whole captain suit. I have a whole costume.
We can't let that go to waste.
We'll have to have some sort of redo. We'll have a redo for everybody that was away. So
Yacht Rock Part 2.
Yacht Rock Part 2.
Might be in summertime. It might be on a yacht, actually.
Yeah, hey, that would be fun. All right. Well, come see us down at the museum. Go see Bailey down at the Diving Mouse, and we will see you next time.
Thank y'all. Have a great day.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.